Hello everybody, this is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft Snapshot Tour. It is Thursday, October 15th, 2015, and yesterday was Snapshot Day, and they released Minecraft 15W42A. And they didn't add too much. They added a few minor things, but most importantly, they fixed the portals. So let's take a look here. And let's see where I left things. Okay, good. We're inside and it's daylight out. Look at that. I didn't have to sleep at the beginning of the episode. Okay, so notice a few things here. Whoa, look at this. I got myself some plants. So I have a little forest of these what do you call them? This is embarrassing. I don't remember the name. The chorus plants, I guess. So I've got them growing here. And I noticed something that the... and you have to... Oh, hello. Pop, pop. You have to pop off the flowers first. And it's useful when they get up to a certain size. When they're 5 or 6 blocks tall is when it's easiest to harvest the plants. Come on. If they get too much taller, it gets more difficult, and you end up doing things like that, and just ruining everything. Anyway. Been doing some playing around. The wiki says something about them being able to grow 22 blocks tall. I think it should be obvious that that is wrong. They can grow much farther than 22 blocks. You can't get a scale here. But these guys, some of these guys are 60-ish blocks tall. So playing around with it and trying to come up with some an understanding of the way they work. So figure out the most effective way of harvesting things. Just playing around with how they grow. And I built a little wall over here. This is the purple brick that you can make with the chorused fruit. Once you cook it, it becomes popped. And I put some end stone here along the wall to see how close it could grow to a wall. And the answer is not at all. It won't. And so then I planted some stuff here to see how I can make it grow straight. And this kind of works. But the plant grows to this particular height, I think it's 6 blocks, and just stops. This is the highest it ever goes. And you can see here, on the fruit here, the white part is very big and star-like. Over here, on these, it's all a tiny little dot. So the fruit, or the flowers, have a life. So this guy, or an age, and this guy's age 0, this is age 0, and all these are age 5. And 5 is as far as it goes, and once it gets to 5, it stops growing. So, I was playing around with it, and like, well, what happened? What if I wanted to grow in a particular way? So like here, now he's still age 0. So the way these things grow is the flower gets replaced with one of the plant, like the stem, and then on that stem block, there's 5 places where the flower can grow. It can grow on top or any one of the 4 sides, and it can grow more than one at a time. So it goes up, and it can then either continue growing up or it grows out to the side, and you can get multiples. So you get these sort of weird shapes like these old Saguaro cactus. And you can get multiple things going like this. And then as it grows, then the flower will age, and sometimes it can age in place. So if I pop off the flower and leave the fruit behind, well, guess what? I can actually place the flower back on the plant. Or once it gets up, like this point where, oh, well, it's pop off the flower. And if I wanted it to keep growing there, so I can tear down these parts of it, grab all the fruit, and if I wanted to, and I put down some blocks to stand on, I can then place a new flower on top there, and it'll keep growing and potentially grow up. I'm here, I'm gonna grab these guys. Come on. Ah, too far away. There's the air conditioning. It is the middle of October, and it is still insanely warm outside. It's cooler today than it was yesterday, but and we got rain yesterday, but it was muggy and hot, and it was just gross. So, the air conditioning is still on. Okay, so I apologize for the sound, but it's still, you know, it's 9:30 at night and it's still super warm outside. So anyway, that will then keep growing, and then I could pop it down. Or let me take it off here so I don't lose the thing. But yeah, so I could, if I wanted to keep growing up, I can sort of take out that, place the flower on top, and it'll keep growing. I can also place the fruit on the side if I want, and sort of encourage it to grow in funky ways. Now, they won't grow, so this guy can grow out, but then he won't grow over this way because, oh well, he might grow this way, so he can grow up. They will not grow so that the flowers are right next to each other. So yeah, these guys, I planted them closer together, and I did it in such a way that, let me turn off the F3, there we go, and we can go up and see just how tall these are. Actually, so we are, these guys started 63. Why 63? And we can go up here. Now this one, am I close enough here? Nope, not yet. Hang on a second. Oh, there we go. Pop, pop, pop. I want to keep these flowers. If you don't get at least a couple flowers off of each of these, you can, in theory, run out. I have plenty in storage, I'll show you. So like here, if I want to kind of encourage this thing to grow up straight, I can just sort of trim it. It's kind of like bonsai, right? I can sort of train it and go pop, and then I can put the flower back on here. Now, this guy in the center and these center ones, like this one keeps growing up to this point and just sort of growing there and aging, becoming, you know, age 5, which I keep calling dying. They're not really dead, but so I've been doing this. Oh, see, he kind of grew out. Oops. Oh, that was dumb. Oh well, pop. And yeah, and I've run out of the flowers. Oh, I did this one wrong. Oh, he grew funky. Okay, I'm out of the flowers, so let's go down and get some. Anyway, you can see some of these are up over 100, Y120, so they're over 64 blocks tall, which is kind of crazy. Pick up the flowers down here. I won't bore you with this. This has been just a lot of planting, pruning, keeping it going, and it's been a lot of work, but it's been kind of an interesting zen kind of activity. Oh, it looks like they got the alternating textures working again. I think that stopped working at some point recently. So, pop. Anyway, some of these are pretty tall. And you could, in theory, incorporate this into a build, I guess. My primary concern with that is, if you did, these are pretty fragile. And not only will hitting one of these at the base knock down the entire thing, but water will also break them. So if I put down, if I get my bucket of water here, and let's see here, how can I do this without, whoa, I think I heard a zombie. It is the middle of the night. So if I put down a thing of water here, of course it flows towards the, put here, bop, the water knocks down the plant, which can be a way of harvesting. You can use water streams to knock down the plants. Then you have to go and manually, you have to manually remove the flowers and manually replant. So there's still kind of an open question of what the best way of farming this stuff is. But it's not difficult, and when they grow that big, it produces a lot of stuff. Let's go inside before that creeper decides to come over, and let's go sleep. Which won't get rid of the creeper, but alright, so I expanded back a little bit. I put in some more storage. And here, so you get the coarse flowers. I've got a whole row of those. You get the fruit. When you put the fruit in the furnace, you get the pop coarse fruit, which you can then put on a 2x2 grid to get these blocks. It's a nice purple block. I mean, they're really kind of a pretty block. And from the blocks, you can make slabs, and you can make pillars by stacking the slabs, and you can make stairs. So there's a lot of potential here, and so I'm just sort of stashing some of the stuff. Oh, the other fun thing with the coarse fruit is, oh, I already showed you. You can eat it and you teleport like an Enderman, which is pretty cool. Not super useful because you have no control over that teleportation, but pretty cool. Let's see. The other thing. I think we used three of these, right? And then we do that, and we take these, and we do that, and we take one of these, and we do that, wooden shovel. No. So you can now make boats out of woods other than oak. So in the snapshot in which they introduced the boats, let's see, is that creeper still there? Nope, where'd he go? Okay, that's fine. So when they, on last week's snapshot, when they introduced boats, oh, hello. When they introduce boats, oops, still getting used to the navigation. Oh, that's interesting. So they made the boats a little bit faster, and they made it so that you have to tap the buttons in order to achieve maximum speed on the boat. Which is kind of cool. I think that's smart. Notice the boats are still leaking. It's okay. Whoa! Wow! Oh! Well, they rotate quickly. Okay, but the nice thing is they don't break. Woohoo! Nice. So look at this. Oh, clay! I need clay. Let's get out. We'll walk overland. Oh, maybe. Oh, well, maybe not. Okay. So, that's interesting. The boat seemed to pull to the left a little bit. Yeah, okay, that's fine. Pop, get out. I think the mobs can still hitch a ride in the boats, but I don't know. I assume so. Oh, I'm hungry. Let's eat. All right. Wow, it gets noisy over there. I may have to turn down those sounds a bit. Yes, I have a silk touch book. And I have a mostly undamaged shovel. Let's make a silk touch shovel, shall we? It only costs 5. There we go, silk touch shovel. Oh, one other thing. Change they made last week, but again, I didn't play last week's thing. You now need blaze powder in order to brew potions. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing, it's a little weird. Let's see, is there any clay over here? I don't know where that came from. Oh, there's some clay. Let's test the silk touch shovel. Yay! So, it's such a pain having to craft clay from the clay balls. Okay, oops. Went a little too far there. There we go. Nice. How much clay do I have? 32. I think that's enough. Nice. Okay. Anything else we need to discuss? I haven't been able to get any more gas tiers. Oh yeah, let's go into the nether. I don't need all this wood. I have torches. We can put this back there. I mostly needed this in order to manufacture a boat. Some dirt, blah, 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 blah. Okay. So I was doing a little exploring in the nether. And, come on. Ooh. Past the like spike. Ooh. So painful. Okay. I hope they fix that. Doing a little exploring in the nether here. Mostly trying to get gas tiers. And, look at this. Hey, guys. What are you doing on my bridge? So, right over here. I should have noticed this. There's another fortress. Oh. Interesting. Uh-oh. Interesting. So this bridge now becomes dangerous since the mobs can sort of push you around. And I don't have my... I didn't grab any fire potions. Interesting. Anyway, so this thing out here, I mean, there's a huge lava lake. So I'm going to have to go explore that fortress, but it looks like, I mean, a huge thing. Oh, hello, Mr. Blaze. And it looks like it goes over here. So I have to figure out how to best exploit that. It's certainly much more convenient than the other fortress, which is way over that direction. If I hop up here, far enough away I can't even see it. It's way over there. So anyway, I may have to expand my nether hub here. My very, very simplistic nether hub to run over to that fortress. Might be some good stuff over there. They're certainly upping the games in terms of the enchants that you find in chests, at least on the end islands. So let's go over. Speaking of which, I want to try something here. So I went pretty much all over. Let's grab the strength potions. So I'm kind of pretty buffed out here. Oh, it's kind of getting close to breaking. This might be a big mistake, but whoa, hello. What's going on? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. What happened there? That makes no sense. I was in the end earlier. Okay. Obviously, there's still some issue with the portal, so I'm going to go check it out, because obviously I'm going to be rolling back to my save, but this should have worked. I did, in this snapshot, I did go into the end. I did some work out there. In preparation for this video. Try this again. Wow. I wonder. Okay, we're gonna try an experiment here. Let's do some science. I'm obviously gonna roll back to a backup that I had. Is that, I don't mind, in the case of game glitches, I don't mind, you know, cheating, using backups, whatever. Because it, there's still developmental snapshots, there's still, whoa, that was interesting. So there's obviously still an issue with the end portal. They fixed the nether portals. I don't know what the, oh, they added a new texture to the shield. It looks like wood now, which makes a certain amount of sense. Okay. I wonder if carrying the shield through the end portal screwed things up. Because that was the difference. Let's go try it. And if that is the case, I will, again, go on the bug tracker and see if somebody has seen the difference. So the way the portals were screwed up was they weren't doing the division by 8-bit going into the nether or coming out of the nether. Basically, they were just taking the coordinates that you were. They were doing the division or multiplication by 8 correctly initially, and then it teleported you to the same coordinates that you were at. Okay, let's see what happens. I'm holding a shield. No, that worked. Okay, so let me go restore from that backup, and maybe we'll try that again. That was weird. Hang on a second. All right, everybody. Hello, welcome back. So, oops, I didn't want to do that. Yeah. So that makes me very nervous for what I'm about to do. I got me some clay. And, what else? What other prep did I have? I have potions of instant health. Oh, you know what I should do? What I'm about to do, doing that. Night vision I don't need. Oh, I have a ton of bottles right here. Screw that. Don't need to make more of them. So I was going to go into White Shield. Interesting. I was going to go into the end and summon another dragon. And the reason being, that I wandered all around on the end island there, and also the other end island that I could get to, and there were no dungeons or anything there, no ships or anything. So it was just let me change the sound there, because friendly creatures, let's take you down a bit because they were super loud. That's better. So that other end island where I was able to get to, there's nothing there. There's none of the new stuff to explore. No end cities, with no shulkers, no end rods, no dungeons, so none of the special loot. There's new enchantments that you could only find in dungeons, and I guess you can get them from fishing and whatnot as well. And trade, you can get a villager that has those enchants as well. But there's just nothing there. I went around the whole area and there's just nothing. And it looks like, although you can, those end islands exist in the world. By which I mean, they, once they're generated, you can bridge your way over to them if you want. What you can't do, or at least it didn't seem to me like you could, shall we say, wait, which guy? Let's leave him behind. I'll take him. Ba 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 ba. I think that's all we need. We'll find out. Okay. Take two. Okay. Interesting. Let's equip the shield. So, it doesn't seem like if you just take an island and you bridge out from it, or fly out from it if you're in creative, it doesn't seem like you can generate new islands. Let's see here. I don't want to be too close to the edge when I do what I'm about to do. Yeah, that seems kind of close. Over here might be good. Yeah. Yeah, let's do it over here. So, every time you spawn a new drag, or every time you defeat the of course I didn't bring Silk Touch. Also be interesting to see if this works. So this is the mechanism that they came up with for you to respawn the dragon. And it's drawn a creeper face out of clay in the end. See if it works with that piece in place. So when this happens, what's going to happen is these towers are going to regenerate. The tops are going to explode. They'll get new crystals, and the dragon will regenerate. And then when I kill the dragon, it'll leave this portal there, but it'll generate a new one and allow another. Hey, dude. Another area to go out and explore. So, okay. I'm probably going to do a time lapse of this, or just cut around it, because you don't need to see the battle again. But, does that do it? No. And did I do this correctly? I never remember how to draw the face. And obviously this is seems like a very temporary mechanic. No, I'm doing something wrong. Okay, hang on a second. Actually, this seems very wrong. Hang on a second. Dude. So I guess Endermen are able to pick up blocks of clay. I was unaware of that. Okay. Okay. I have it right here. Something's not working. Okay. Well, and the enemy are gonna steal all my clay. Okay, well, anyway, you get the idea. This is how it's supposed to work. They shouldn't be able to hit you when they're carrying stuff. Come on, give me my clay back. Not that I really need it. Thank you. That's one change I do like. Alright, well, I'm gonna call that an episode, because we've been going a little long here. And even with the cutaways, this is supposed to work. I have done it in... Whoa, don't run off the edge there. I've done it in creative mode, just to sort of test it. It does work. One thing I found is if you do the creeper face on one of the outer islands, it waits until you come back here in order to regen the dragon, which I thought was kind of interesting. I made this a little safer over here. I'll show you this real quick, and then we'll call that an episode. I improved my little stairs here a bit, and I want to put some slabs on it or something. I made a little Enderman hidey hole over here, but I put some rails, made it just in general a little bit safer. So you can come up here and throw the ender pearl through the portal. So anyway, I guess that's it. I will figure out this re-summoning the dragon bit, because I want more portals, because I want to be able to go play with the end cities, and I haven't really been able to do that yet. Because that's where all the cool new stuff is. So, anyway, we'll call it there. I will figure it out, and we will, as soon as I can get it working, we'll come back and actually respawn the dragon and take care of all that stuff. Hello, that was weird. Yeah, clearly, end portals still have some issues. Cool. All right, thank you for watching. This is Theron. This is Minecraft Maker, and this has been the Minecraft 1.9 Snapshot Tour. All right, I will see you later. Bye.